Hello, good evening. We hope you like the new music, and we hope too you like the new programme. Being kept. Well, now your match carries tonight. The national match of the day, Luton Town, the third division league leader since August, versus Plymouth Argyle. And the South East from the first division, West Ham United versus Manchester United. And the North and the Midlands, Manchester City versus Stoke City. And the South and the West, Bristol City versus Millwall. In Wales, Wrexham versus Brentford. And in Northern Ireland, Ards versus Glentoran. But we start with the match of the day, Luton Town versus Plymouth. And your commentator is Kenneth Wilson-Holm.
Kenilworth Road, Luton. Home of Luton Town, the third division league leaders who've suffered three defeats in a row, but anxious today to get back onto the winning trail and consolidate their position as the front runners for promotion into the second division. Luton Town in the white shirts lost 5-1 last week. They've just made one change in their side, so no panic measures from this team. Keane is relegated to substitute, and all the Luton fans hope that their number 8, Malcolm McDonald, there he is, the top scorer, will get back into the goal trail. One of the most dangerous men in the 6-yard box when he's really on song. Signed from Fulham during the close season. A Plymouth Argyle are managed by Billy Bingham, a former Luton Town player. They've got 4 youth internationals in their side, and they've recruited a lot of talent from the West and the Southwest, not generally regarded as a great area for footballers. And they have perhaps the greatest player in the third division, number 2, Norman Piper, a player whom many of the big clubs would like to sign. The referee, Mr. Davey of Mansfield, checking with his two linesmen, Mr. Lewis of Wisbeach, Mr. Smith of Groby in Leicestershire, and it's Plymouth Argyle to kick off. And a shock straight away, the man wearing number 2, Norman Piper, lining up with the forwards. And this is Piper, an aggressive midfield player. Number 11, French for Luton. Goal kick. Graham French, former youth international, Swindon Town player. And it's Martin Clamp, Plymouth goalkeeper, signed on a free transfer from Coventry. Incidentally, it's almost a year since Alex Stock took over here at Luton, and Luton's opponents, the first time Alex Stock was in charge, Plymouth Argyle. So we're back to square one. For the number 6, playing the back 4 for Plymouth. To Luton as Foster, the former Birmingham player, now number 5 for Plymouth. Oh, a lovely move, and it's McDonald almost in on that one. It's a corner. Corner to Luton. That was a foul by Rickard. On more, Rickard number 9, free kick to Luton. Going to be taken by Bannister, finding French. John Moore. Plymouth's ball. Run. Free kick, a foul on Sullivan. Free kick to Plymouth. Sullivan to take the kick. Woom, Ma getting a lucky rebound then. Bickle to Ma, and Luton in a bit of trouble. Corner kick to Plymouth. There's Ryan, the man who came to Luton's rescue that time. Corner. Now Maher. Oh, and Luton were a bit all at sea again. Number nine is Rickard. Maher to take the corner, and he's going to try the long one this time. Lean, and the goal line well defended by his well positioned Luton defence. That's David Lean, came up at the last moment for that corner. Collins forward to McDonald, maybe a shot. Well, he hit it hard enough. Just got underneath it. He's gone onto the right wing. Slough. Allen. Well, the crowd think it should have been a penalty. And somebody's hurt. It's Reynolds, I think. Yes, Reynolds. Number 10, Keane Allen. The man who was brought down in that incident, and some of the crowd thought that he was fouled, but the referee waved play on. Reynolds all right again. And a throw by Allen for Luton. Rickard to Piper. He hit that one beautifully on the run. Sullivan. The Piper charged in the back by Nicol. Free kick to Plymouth. Sullivan to take the free kick to Maher. Doubt whether French has got the speed. My goodness, he has. 20 minutes gone. No score. Allen with the throw for Luton. That was a foul and the referee has blown. Poor man who committed a foul on French. Bannister with the free kick. French. McDonald. And I thought that was in the net. It was a cheeky one for McDonald. It completely wrong foot in the hole of the defence. Corner to Luke. Piper. Now Bickle, back to Rickard, and that was terribly slack defensive play by Luton Town. They thought the ball would go through to the goalkeeper. Nobody was watching Bickle at all. Number three for Luton. Four with the throw for Plymouth. Piper. arrive, having played the ball, hurries off into space. Reynolds to Sullivan. Piper not very effective in the air, he's not tall enough for that, likes to have it on the ground. Four to Davy. Davy going over the ball to that one. And he's caught Bannister. Almost see the stud marks. And Davy is going to be booked. Quite rightly, he clipped Allen from behind. So Steve Davy. Certainly asked for that. Moore to take the free kick for Luton. McDonald. Allen. Slough. Another corner. Six. Sir Davy must have caught his breath when he saw that ball deflected. Or rather clamp in the Plymouth goal. And McDonald, a fine save! And clamp having a splendid match for Plymouth. And McDonald, he headed that well, he must have thought he was a certain score. Collins with the corner for Luton. Ryan to Collins. Tees, he's got it. What a brilliant save by the number four, Lean. Lean right in the back of the net. And I think Foster's hurt. Foster got clipped round the ear, but that time Clamp was completely beaten. John Collins, number seven, a former Queen's Park Rangers player. Minute of injury time now. Referee signalling the goalkeeper to be quick with his goal kicks. This is Maher and Sullivan streak down the left wing. So it goes to the right to Davy. Oh, a good ball to Rickard, it's a goal! Oh, a lovely move by Plymouth. There's Rickard, the scorer. And Sandy Davy was left hopelessly exposed then. Plymouth used the full length of the pitch for this goal. Clamp the goalkeeper up to Maher. Now he moves to the left and he switches the point of the play by hitting it over to the right. And Davy snaps it up. Now he draws the defenders. He takes on three of them before he's slipping that ball. A brilliant pass. And young Rickard shows great skill moving over to it, hitting the ball on the wrong side of the keeper. Well taken, well made goal. It's after 46 and a half minutes. We've had a minute and a half of injury time. Luton now in serious trouble. And the whistle goes for half-time. Plymouth Argyle leading by 1-0. The goal scorer was Rickard. There he is, Derek Rickard. His first ever goal in league football. as Luton prepare to kick off. Billy Bingham, the Plymouth Argyle manager, must be a very happy man. His team in the lead, 1-0. And it's Luton who kick off in the second half. A team really in trouble now. Allen, now French, now McDonald to Allen, now French. Well, Luton set off at a fair old pace again, but they started like this in the first half and then lose a goal in the last minute. Has got the beating of four completely for speed. French leaving the throw to Allen. Tees to French. And free kick. The thought of healthy position in which to give away a free kick. Indirect free kick. Ah, McDonald is never really on for him to knock that one down into the net. 10 minutes of the second half gone. Luton Town in trouble, a goal down at home to Plymouth. Positive goalkeeping though by Clamp. He had to come out, go straight for the ball. Well, Tees is all right, but he doesn't look too happy with life. He really took a bang right in the mouth. Looks as if he might have lost a tooth or something. It's a drop ball. And a free kick given against Rickard for holding. Free kick going to be taken by Ryan. Trouble, yes, he's in trouble. The train is coming back on to him. Well, Well, he's only going to be running repairs, but he still doesn't look very happy with life, does he? McDonald with the throw, and again, it's a corner to Luton. French to take the corner kick. The Luton substitute. Now David. Well, that was a good run by David. He was being harassed all the time by Slough. And Keane has come on. There's Keane come on instead of Tees. Tees has decided to call it a day. Bannister to Allen. To Keane. Piper got out of trouble by Reynolds. Number 10 is Bickle, number 6 Moore, and Bickle pushing Moore in the back. Free kick to Luton Town. The fault here lies with the white-shirted Moore, number 6, who doesn't look where his goalkeeper is. It's a simple ball. He plays it wide of his goalkeeper, throws the goal away, but give Bickle his credit. He moves quickly to it, sticks out a foot, and gets a soft second goal. So, Bickle the scorer. But really, the man who threw it away was Moore. 27 minutes of the second half gone. Luton in real trouble. Two down. Well, what? 70 minutes to go. French. Keane to take the throw. By Moore. It's John Moore who made such a hopeless hash of that pass which led to the second goal. And a foul. Foster to take the free kick. Plymouth Argyle love to play against the big boys and cut them down to size. Recently they knocked in six against Torquay United, who are with the promotion runners. Mahan, number 11. Keane. Donald back to Keane. French. Keane to Collins. Foster, the number five, up with the attack to Rickard. Tonight's Keane, Keane to Collins. McDonald to Keane, but Plymouth have funneled back. There's a whole forest of green shirts back there now, including number 11, Maher. Goal kick, cleverly won by Maher, and then to play it against French. Allen. Well, the fellow clamp gets to it again. At the 11th corner kick for Luton. You don't win matches with corner kicks, you win them by goals. And Plymouth have got two, Luton none. Well, the small band of Plymouth supporters chanting, easy, easy. Well, can't blame them. Well, the 45 minutes are up now. So it's injury time between Plymouth and Victory. And the first Plymouth goal came in injury time in the first half, so the whistle goes for the end of the match, and Luton Town have lost their fourth match in succession, and Plymouth Argyle have won it by 2-0, the goal scorers, Rickard getting the first one. There's Rickard, who got the first goal, his first ever league goal in his fourth league game, and Bickle, number 10, got the second one.
Well, that defeat took Luton Town off the top of the third division table for the first time since the end of August, and at the moment they're having a bad time. Among the spectators at the match today was Alan Hardacre, Secretary of the Football League.
Well, it's good to see the Secretary of the Football League at a third division game, Mr. Hardacre. What do you think of the standard of play generally in the third division?
I think it's very high. This is the fourth game I've seen this week, and it certainly wasn't the least entertaining of them all.
Now, Luton Town are a good example of a progressive club with restaurants and this wonderful club they've got and a retail shop. Is this the general trend you find now with football league clubs?
I think it is, yes. They seem to be trying to get money from other sources than football, which they've got to do to Liverpool.
Now, they've also got a millionaire chairman. Is this too getting rather a general trend, getting very rich men to run you?
Well, I mean, no disrespect to the chairman of Luton, but this millionaire chairman is becoming rather commonplace. But you're getting men of business with drive, this is the thing, and they come in and they try to make the extra activities of the club help to pay for the football.
Would you think this is a good thing?
I think it's a marvellous thing. I think they've got this has got to be the trend in the next 10 years.
Now, what about a team like Plymouth, who are way in the backwards, really? Many people say they don't like to go down to Plymouth, but this looked a very good young side today, didn't it?
I thought it was an excellent side. I thought they played remarkably well.
And yet it's said that down in the southwest and the west there aren't any good players, and yet most of these players are locals, youngsters.
Well, you better not tell some of the first division clubs or we might find some scouts moving from the northeast.
Now, if we could just get back to today's game in detail, Mr. Hardacre, what did you think of it, really? What really impressed you about it?
Well, the standard of entertainment, it was an exciting match, it was played hard, it was played fair, but I think the outstanding thing to me, and I'm sure it'll show in television, was their goalkeeper. I think it was his day to howl, and I don't think they would have beaten him if they'd tried all day.
And yet this is a goalkeeper who's picked up on a free transfer.
This happens.
Now, we had two goals in this match. I wonder whether you could think back now after a few minutes out after the game, think back to these two goals.
Well, I think the first goal of Plymouth was a marvellous goal. It was worked very nicely. But, of course, the second one was just one of those unfortunate happenings in the pass back when the full-back or the centre-half, where it was, slipped. But think of the number of times the ball was cleared off the line, and think of the number of saves, how many goals there might have been.